Hi guys, it's me again. I thought I'd just show you a few bits. I've been like faffing around for the past hour or so trying to get ready. And yeah, I'm going out afterwards. I'm going to meet one of my friends. We're just going to catch up and have some lunch. But now, and I've got 2 days off actually. I'm off today, which is Friday, and then I'm off on the Monday as well. So I'm really excited, feel relaxed. I'm going to go to a spa on Monday, hopefully for a massage. I really need it. I don't know whether it's just the fact that it's, like, the weather's changing. I just feel like a bit, I don't know, tense and tired all the time. So hopefully this will just help me to like relax a bit. And with the weather as well, it's like freezing. One minute it's like, the weather goes up and down constantly. It's like 1 minute it's 5 degrees, 1 minute it's 3 degrees, 1 minute it's, well, that's in the mornings really, and then it goes up to, I think, about maximum like 13 degrees average at the moment. Which, yeah, it's weird because in the day you're wearing your full like big coat and you're hot, and then like in the mornings you're freezing, so there's no like middle. Apparently it's supposed to be like the coldest winter since 2012. So the first item I've got is these Converse that I've wanted probably for the past year and a half. And they were sold out from Dover Street Market for ages. And I signed up to make sure I got an alert saying, oh, we're back in stock. So these are the Converse des Garçons. That's how you pronounce it. Which I think they're really cute. I see loads of people walking around with, sorry, I don't mind the laces, but I see loads of people walking around in West End with, well, not West End, but just in general, mainly West End, with either like the heart that's on the lower part of the shoe, or yeah, like these ones I haven't seen as much. I think I've seen like one girl in them, so I feel like these are really cool, really different. I like the trainer. It's a lot thicker than the normal Converse, and they're really comfortable actually. At first I thought they might look a bit like clown shoes, but I think they're, I don't know, they're cute. Before, you'd have the Converse logo at the back with the actual like Converse writing, which used to really get my nerves when I was younger, because once, if you scuff your foot once, that's it. Like, that writing, you would have like Converse, or, do you know what I mean? Something like, you'd end up scuffing it and it wouldn't actually be the full word. But now they've kind of done like just a white logo. So don't know why they've done that this time. Maybe it's because of the collaboration or something. But yeah, these are really cute. I think they were 115 pounds, and then postage and packaging was about £5, I think. So yeah, I think they were worth the wait. Wish I could have got them earlier. I had a look on like places like Depop, but people were still trying to charge like £70-80 for trainers that have been used, and I was like, that's disgusting. Like, why would I pay that much money for something that's secondhand? It doesn't make any sense. So I've got them now, so hopefully I'll get a good wear out of them. If you want to see the box, this is what they came in. I'm guessing all the Converses with the collaboration come in this box. It's just a plain white box, to be honest. If you want to know what size I am, I'm a size 6, which says there. And yeah, so yeah, £110, as you can see on the logo. You can order it online on doverstreetmarket.com or .co.uk. Which is, there's a store actually as well, if you want to check it out. The box is wrapped in their paper. And yeah, in Topshop they have Beauty Mart bit, which I popped into the other day, and I kind of go in there quite a bit just to pick up a few bits, just because they stock, again, international brands. And I previously purchased the Balmain Paris Silk Perfume, which is, as you can see, this is what it is. And they have it in Topshop as well. So it's £24. It's just a silk perfume basically that makes your hair smell nice, and also it's got like really good ingredients in it. So it's got like jojoba oil, which is good because it's not too oily, but then it still gives you like a nice shine. And it's really good. It's quite similar to like Moroccan oil. If you're interested in trying it out, it's a bit cheaper than Moroccan oil, and I feel like it's a bit lighter as well. Yeah, take a look. It smells really nice. It smells like talcum powder, so have a look and see what you think. Earlier about the weather and how cold it is in England, we still get sun obviously in the winter, which is sometimes can be annoying when you're driving because it's so bright that you need sunglasses. So I've kind of selected a couple of sunglasses that I'm going to choose to transition from the summer through to the winter. These are the Dior Reflect sunglasses. I bought them about a year and a half ago. I really like them. They're really cool, edgy. I feel like they make an outfit look like we have a leather jacket on, black boots. It just makes you just look really cool. So, I don't know. But yeah, these were, at the time, I think they were £300. But, because I'm smart, they, in John Lewis, they had, like, basically there's a website called Pret-to-Fall. I don't know, I'll put it in the link below. But basically they had like a discount sale on at the time. Let me take these off. And they are like a reputable website. So I went to John Lewis and said to them, these are on sale for £200. Can you price match them? Because they were £300. So I ended up getting them for £200. So just be aware, if you ever see anything on a website that you think is like a legitimate website, maybe just check. It just saves you having to wait for like the postage, delivery. Yeah, to get them, to try them on, you get to see them. Whereas on an online website with sunglasses, you just don't know whether you're actually going to like them or not. That's my first pair, like my go-to pair. I feel like I would wear them more when I'm going out or something, like a nice lunch. And these are from Urban Outfitters. And these are cool again. Another leather jacket situation. I don't know if anyone needs a pair in their life. They're a bit bigger than the normal average size, like round sunglasses, which I think because my face, I've got quite a long face, I feel like it kind of, I've got big eyes as well, it kind of fits my face a bit better. But these were like $12.99 or something. So they're just easy sunglasses that I'll just have in my car and just chuck on when I'm ready to drive. So yeah, I think you can still get them in Urban Outfitters. I think I got them back in probably about in August or something, but they kind of run throughout the whole, like throughout all seasons really. So if you can't get them in this color, these are gold by the way, with like a greeny black lens, but you could probably get them in other colorways maybe. Yeah, have a look online, have a look in store. And if you like them, then yeah, have a look and see if you can get them. Yeah. Next pair, very similar to the previous pair that I showed you. But these are just a black version really, so similar to my Dior ones as well, but in between. So you've got the round shape again. They are a bit smaller. I haven't worn these actually. I bought them and I think they were like end of August. Regent Street, they've opened up a new store called Weekday, and these were, I think they were like £12 or £8 or something like that again. But I just like them because they are like matte, they're like a matte frame, and then again the black lens, they're just cool, easy to wear, and cheap, so I don't have to worry about breaking them or scratching them. Whereas with my Dior ones, I've already scratched the lens. I'm gonna have to get the lens replaced before I lost like the nose, the nose pod things. I lost them, so I had to get them replaced as well. So it's just realistically, sunglasses, even if they are the most expensive sunglasses, they are all the same really. I don't think there's much difference really. Obviously it's just for the design, certain brands bring out nicer designs. Pair of sunglasses are these glasses from, I think they're from ASOS. Let me just try them on for you. These are like the Instagram baddie sunglasses. I went to Cuba a couple months ago and I wore them in Cuba and I thought they looked really cool with my outfit. And they're just cute really. They just make you look a bit more like a bit geeky, but at the same time a bit more like sexy geeky thing. I like this fact that the frame is more squared off on the corners, but then it's kind of still like an aviator style. I think I got these on ASOS. They were like either £12 again or £18, affordable. And I just like the fact that they have like the yellow lens. I really wanted the Dior, the new ones that came out. I can't remember what they're called. So are they retro? I'll put the name down below. So that's the end of my sunglasses little haul. The next thing I've got is also popped into Liberty. And I was I don't know, like, I'm always looking for, like, really nice perfumes, things that smell nice, things that make me smell nice. As you know, previously I showed you my candles from Zara and then the Zara perfume. So I bought another perfume, and this one was a bit more, like, of the premium end of the spectrum. It's the Le Labo. Don't know why I'm saying like that. I'm not French, but yeah, you get what I mean. They're handmade perfumes that basically they mix together when you're in store. And then I got the 50ml because a 50ml is £120. And then I think, I can't remember how much 100ml was, but I was like, no. So the Noir 29 was my choice. They also put the name, your name on the box with the date you purchased the perfume, which is really cool. And it's just like a really nice, it makes you just feel really special, really. Especially if it was like a present for someone. Like, if someone bought me that for Christmas, I'd be like, oh my gosh, so nice. This is the bottle that comes in. I noticed, like, when I'm carrying it around, I can see that the actual fragrance is more, it's like an oil. Like, it's actually weird. It's actually, that's how strong the scent is. It's like an actual oil. Like, let me just spray it. But it smells like, it's really florally, but at the same time, like, musky, but at the same time, like, fresh, if that makes sense. It's really nice. You need to try it, if you haven't smelled it before. And yeah, so that's, I feel it's proper lingers. Like, I've smelled it on other people before as well, and it's literally, like, follows you around the room. So that's what I'm always looking out for, perfumes that last and that are worth the money. I'd rather spend £120 on the perfume than spend £80 on a perfume that only lasts for like 10 minutes, whereas this would last you throughout the whole day. You don't have to keep topping it up. So realistically, it's working out to be like more affordable in the long run. Like, this probably would last me for about 3 months or something, whereas maybe a normal perfume would only last me about a month and a half. So I'll let you know how much I use it and give you an update. Yeah. Last but not least, I've just got my jacket to show you. I bought this in my Selfridge about a month and a half ago. So I'm trying to catch up. Obviously, I'm new, so I need to show you as much product as possible and stuff that I've bought. So if they don't have it in stock, I can also link stuff that's similar below. But this jacket, I just thought it's really cute. It's just something you can throw on. It wasn't expensive at all. It was only like £55. So for, it's not real, it's PU, but I just like the design. Like, if I could design like a leather jacket, this is how I would want to design it. Something that's like, it's not too over the top, but it's still a bit jazzy, a bit extra to go out. It just jazzes up your outfit a bit. There's a lot of like flat studs all over, on the like arm details, for instance, and even on the back, the shoulder, there's like studs as well. But I just think it's really cute. Yeah, this jacket, £55, Miss Selfridge. Don't really shop in Miss Selfridge much. Had a look in there the other day, saw it, thought buy it. I think that's one of those things where, like, Miss Selfridge isn't, I'm not the type of girl that would shop in Miss Selfridge, but I think, yeah, they do have the odd bit that you can pick up and be like, oh my gosh, I can make this look really nice on. So really easy to wear. So yeah. I wanted to show you my nails. I got them done the other day, and they are the whole like chrome effect thing that's really like trendy at the moment. If you can see, like, they rub on the powder onto your nail. I got these done in shellac because I just thought, I don't really wear nail varnish. I only get shellac just because I don't like going to the nail shop much, and I don't like actually painting my nails. I don't like acrylics that much. I have had acrylics before, but I just find I find that after a while I just get fed up of having to go back to the shop to get them done, or the maintenance of them. Whereas at least with shellac, it's, or gel, whatever you want to call it, at least it's like you could kind of push it out for 3 weeks and then go back and get them done again. So yeah, they are like a unicorn effect, which is like cute at the moment. They're £30, they were £30, and I like them. So yeah, I think I'm gonna get them again. This is my first time. I know certain shops charge more for the chrome nails. I paid an extra £7. Normally it's £22 for gel, and then for the chrome it was £7. So Also, music that I'm into at the moment. So, Chris Brown, I know everyone's not his biggest fan. I know he's trying to like build his career back up. He had a documentary on Netflix actually, which was quite interesting to watch. It was just basically about how he, obviously the incident with him and Rihanna, and how he handled that. It's not really bad, it's not a good thing. But he went through a lot of depression as well, and he kind of like voiced his side of the story really, which was interesting to watch. And besides from that situation, obviously I'm a fan of Rihanna, I'm a fan of him, and he's brought out a new album, and this is one of the songs that I really like at the moment, so I'll play you like a 10 to 20 second clip or something of it. So yeah, that one, or one of the other songs that I like is Tough Love as well. I like the tune. And then one more song is Paradise, which thanks guys for watching. This is, I know it's only my second video and it might seem weird that I might not be talking to loads of people, but whoever's watching, I really appreciate it, and hope something that you've liked that I've shown. Keep giving me, if there's anything that you want me to do or anything that you want me to review or even just discuss, as I mentioned before, my friends and I are looking to do some videos based on like real life serious topics. So if there's anything that you are dealing with at the moment or within like either mental health or even just relationship advice, let me know, message me or leave a comment down below, and hopefully I'll be posting again very soon. And yeah, thank you for your time and have a nice rest of the day. Take care, see you later.